what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a quick introduction. Rami asked me, what do you do, Constantin? You know, what is the job? You've been here for 4 months. So I have a few slides that were presented to Maru Chamas, Nicolas, that Joanna, myself, and somebody else presented. I will take you through a few of these slides just to give you a feel of what are we doing here and what we're trying to do in the ecosystem here in Lebanon. Okay, so here, for instance, if I ask you in terms of what are the services, primarily it was hosting. So you have a hosting services here, you manage your business, you might have some training like the one we have here. We want to add other services because we believe today that there is a lot of money that is pouring into this the market. You know, in total we have about $600 million that is being poured in terms of equity funding to a number of the startups, a number of the SMEs. We realize that this money alone and just having somebody on the board every 3 months is not enough. So what we need to do, like what Berry Tech has been doing, it's not only about hosting, it's not only about training, it's about hand-holding the hands of the founders and their team and helping them address the key problems that they are facing. So this process is a process that we define as coaching on one side and mentoring on the other. Now, what is the difference between the two? Rami, do you know what the difference between the two is?
Sorry, I wasn't following.
So Rami was not following. So this is good. So this is how you make sure that Rami will be following because he knows that the next question will come to him. No, but the difference between the two, the way we defined it is when we do coaching, we will spend 2 to 3 days per month per company over a long period of time. So this could be, marhaba. Ça va? Très bien. Je vous laisse prendre. Basita. It's like we follow the company and we follow it in a long-term relationship. So this is 2 years, it could be 3 years, it could be more. And we don't do it like 1 day every 3 months, we do it 2 to 3 days every month. So this is an in-depth relationship that we have with the companies to be able to implement. The mentoring is more of a short-term punctual. You have a problem, a list of problems, you want to address them, you get two or three people that are experts, and then you go and you're trying to get different answers to what your problem is going to be. We will implement both. One has been done from MIT, had this virtual mentoring services that they've implemented a long time ago. Nicolas has been to the campus back 2 months ago. Christelle was with him and a couple of other people. So we want to implement the mentor. I'll be one of the mentors here. The other one, I've been with Stanford. I'm a graduate from both MIT and Stanford. Stanford has a coaching one that we have tested already in West Africa and we're testing in East Africa. And this is what we try to do. So we will implement both the mentoring and the coaching system. Now, what is the coaching all about? The change is here. What we try to do is basically it's a win-win for the company owners, but it's also a win-win for the venture capital or private equity funds. Because by doing this, you are ensuring that your money is being well spent, you're ensuring that there is a higher level of value creation in the company. So this is one of the reasons that we have. So for the company leaders, it would be to make them ready for future funding rounds, implement a clear path for growth and transformation. For the coaches and the VC funds, it's to have a track of how we want to work together, what are the pain points that you're facing, and how we could help you address these pain points. So we're implementing this. We have tested it for the past 4 months. We worked with about 14 different companies, and we have been getting a lot of very strong feedback on it, and we have decided to formalize it and to institutionalize it as of January of next year. Okay, so this is a bit what the introduction that we have. So I'm just going to show you what are the typical key deliverables. So these are the list of the companies that we have. We have high touch ones, cardio diagnostics, we have L'Atelier Jumel, B-Synchro, Arima, and you have a number of low touch, 2 to 3 meetings. Jardin Eden is here, Rima is representing it, and we have a number of other companies that are coming either from l'Abdi and Fact. Je t'ai mis là-dessus même, je t'ai mis sur la liste, tu vois. Donc ça c'est pour te dire que tu es accepté dans le processus. What we do is we deliver workshops. Today is one typical workshop. Today's workshop is going to be on building a transformational plan, but I will focus specifically on deliverables that you need. So by the end of the 4 hours, each one of you as owners of companies, you will have your own roadmap of what you want to focus on over the next 6 to 12 months. And we will do this through a process, and this process hopefully will help you in terms of identifying these opportunities for value creation, and then ideally, if you don't have the capacity, trying to work with a coach, a Berry Tech coach or others to be able to help you implement it. Okay, so these are the list of workshops that I've delivered over the past. It goes from getting ready for investments, personal development planning, financial management, building high-performing teams, sales and marketing strategy. So it covers different touch. It's to make sure that everybody speaks the same language. So what we wanted is, instead of my conducting the training with only you, we invite, and typically you have 30, 40 different companies that come to these workshops, and then we go and we implement these within these companies. So these are typically the sort of deliverables. So if you work with a coach, what typically you will get, we will start today, we'll do a SWOT analysis. Today you'll have also a balanced scorecard that is mentioned here, so this will be a performance management framework. But you have a number of other deliverables that could go from hiring, could go to setting a board, it could go to understanding what sort of organization structure you need to have in place. So all these deliverables are deliverables that you will work with the coach in order to be able to implement them within your company, and hopefully these are creating values to your organization and to the venture capital fund that is funding. Any questions? We will share the slides on this. So this is an example. This was last week. So I flew in. One of the companies is Bsynchro. Bsynchro has been also funded by Berry Tech Fund 1. We also are funding it in Berry Tech Fund 2. They started with, how much they start with, Sami? Half a million?
600,000.
600,000. Now they're raising about $5 million worth of equity. They have made an acquisition in Bahrain. He asked me to come, Constantin, I need to integrate the two companies. We need to work through. So what we did is we went, these are the actually pictures that I took with my poor camera on this thing. We have done here, during the journey, we've done a SWOT analysis of the company. We looked at their value chain. How do they go and they create value from the way they develop the product to the way they get their revenue and to the way they support. We went through their sales and marketing model. We looked at their segmentation. We looked at the customer segmentation. We looked at their product offering. We looked at how best in terms of channels to address these needs through the product. We looked at their competitive positioning. How do they compare? Who are the competitors? What are the areas, how they differentiate one versus the other? So this was also, each one of these bubbles is at least an hour type of workshop. We looked at the leadership competencies that they want to hold themselves accountable. We also looked at the key strategic initiative, which is what you will be doing today. We looked at the key performance indicators, and at the end, we identified the synergies between Bsynchro and Arima. So this was an example. This is a real case that happened last week, and these are so we start with expectation, we look at the key changes in Arima, we looked at strengths, we looked at weaknesses, we looked at opportunities, we looked at threats facing them, we looked at their value chain, we looked at their sales and marketing strategy, their customers, the markets, the channels of distribution, the product, the competitive differentiator. All this was discussed. So this is all what is here is coming from the team, not from me, but from the entire team. So typically when a coach works with you, this is the sort of thing that will come from the team. We then looked at their competitive positioning. Who are the competitors? What are the features? How do they differentiate versus the features? We looked at the leadership competencies. And from this, we looked at a transformation roadmap. So what is the roadmap in terms of KPIs? What is the roadmap in terms of key strategic initiative? This is what you will have by the end of the 4 hours. So you'll have a first pass at what is going to be your roadmap for transformation by the end of the 4 hours. And then we looked at next steps. This is an example of how a coach works with a company in a series of workshops to... Now, the last slides I will have, these are testimonials. One is from Ziad, is the boss but they're all, I don't want to beat the drum. But basically, the feedback has been very good and overwhelmingly positive. This is what's important. So if you want to put it as a process, the way it works is that you have, these are the workshops, the 10 workshops that I mentioned, that are done to everybody. These are free workshops. Everybody comes and attend these workshops. Then we take the learning and we go with in-company workshops. So we take it, what makes sense for you? I forgot your first name.
Tufi.
So in Tufi, he would say, Constantin, I have most of this. I want to focus purely on customer segmentation. Or I want to focus on looking at my cash flow. How can I optimize it? Then I will work with Tufi and the team and taking the learning from this in order to apply to what this is in company, to his own specific needs. And then Tufi will work on a number of other initiatives to come up with his transformation plan. And then the role of the coach is not only to help him put together a transformation plan, but to help Tufi in implementing it. So, and this is not coming here as a consultant for about 2 or 3 hours and then leaving. It's really about regular visit with Tufi and the team to follow up. So this process is a process that has been tested, has been developed. Now in Lebanon, you have hundreds of people who say, I'm a coach. You know, and you have maybe several hundred, they say, I'm a mentor. The reality is that you cannot be a coach if you don't have experience in creating, in building, in growing small, medium-sized enterprises. So you need this track record, you need a methodology, and you need at the same time to know how you're going to take these companies and being able to grow. And you need to know this across sectors and across functions. So you could talk HR the same way you could talk strategy, the same way you could talk finance, and you need to be able to talk across different sectors, from cardio monitoring to security services to honey making. This is the sort of thing that we're looking, and we're in the process of identifying coaches, training these coaches, and expanding the program. We're going to start with 8 to 10 companies, so Joanna will work with me, we're going to have, and as we grow the number of companies, we will then hire coaches to be able to do and support the service. Any questions? Tufi, is this clear?
Yeah.
Does this make sense to you? Sure. Is this a service that you will, if you want to talk, or, j'ai oublié votre prénom?
Moi?
Oui. Ah, donc c'est Amal et Tufi. Donc ça c'est parce que vous êtes les deux compagnies qui sont, normalement c'était pour vous deux le service. On a eu d'autres personnes qui sont venues. Donc ça c'est les, et bien sûr Rami et son équipe ici. Ok, so this is what we will be, donc this is the pointer, very good, I'm learning. Ok, so this is, now there is a template. We will not use this template, we're going to give you a template. It's a big, large. It's basically the business model canvas that has been expanded. And this template, normally with the coach, you work and then you work together on this. What we're going to do today is we're going to focus on one, which is basically the diagnostic. And we will do, you will do a diagnostic of your own company. And we will also work on the operating plan. So we will focus on this. You will work with your team on putting together your diagnostic, and we will work on putting together the operating plan. And this operating plan is what are the steps that you need in order to be able to address the gaps that you have or the opportunities that you have. Okay, is this clear? Any questions? Okay, so I mentioned what are the services? Coaching. I think it's clear, 2 to 3 days per month. We have compensation for the coach. It's a long time, 2 to 3 years. The mentoring is more punctual, 2 to 3 hours on a volunteering basis. We have a number of workshops. Very important, we're doing leadership assessments. So when we work, for instance, with Ziad and his team, we will do an assessment based on the leadership characteristics, doing a 360 degrees assessment, then personal development plan that we will have, and then a regular personal coaching with the coach. So this is on top of the mentoring and on top of the coaching. And lastly, but very important, is to build a community. What Rami is doing across the three campuses, we want to do because there is a lot of best practice sharing across the companies that we work with. And this is something that we would like to maintain, because what is applicable here can be also applicable to another company. And we, as coaches that have these best practices, will tend to share them so that to build the overall knowledge level of the companies that we work with. Okay, I think this is it. We could move the profile. This is clear, the rest, anyway, so this, now to change, Akif Ben Khayyel, escape. Any questions before I change to the slide sets? No question? You need a question, because I don't know how to, is this clear? Transformation. C'est parfait. No question, Rami, tu as des questions, est-ce que c'est clair? C'est clair? Ok, tu signes le chèque, là, pour financer le... Yeah. Actually, it's done. I mean, yesterday I got the approval from Arun and from Nicolas to fund this project. So this was an important milestone. Thank you. So we have, so we're starting on this initiative, and hopefully most of you will be benefiting from it. Okay, what we're going to do now is the transformation plan. I want to take you through the logic. How many of you have put together their business plan? Business plan, Berry Tech. Who didn't put together a business plan? Half a business plan over here. Everybody else has half a business plan over here. No business plan, half a business plan?
Not a formal
business plan. Okay, all right. The point here is not to do a business plan, but I want to put it in context of what we call a transformation plan, and I'm going to zoom in on two aspects. One is what I call the gap analysis, and the second one, which I call the balance scorecard. So this is what we're going to zoom in, and this is what you're going to do the work. So I'll do some talking, and then we have flip charts, and you're going to do the work, and then come and present and get feedback on what you're presenting. Okay, so the whole point is we show you the methodology. I showed you how it was applied to one of the companies last week in Bahrain. You're going to use it in your company. You're going to come and present it. We give you feedback on what you're presenting, and hopefully this will help in terms of integrating the process in the way you run your company. Rami, c'est clair?
Clair.
Okay, no, but it's okay. Rami, okay, so what is basically the transformation plan? This is a methodology that has been developed by number. This is the one that Stanford had put together. We have shaped it. We have, and this is focusing primarily on startups and SMEs. So we're looking, and the whole point behind it is to be able to prepare them to face institutional investors. So how do you go, kifak? Takhartu ya ammi. I should say, kifak? Walbanat khalaytoun bilbayt? Mish ma ittafaqna hik. Anjad ma, they're not coming? Okay, very good. So ahla wa sahla fikoum. Okay, marhaba. Kifak? Ziyad, good? Okay, so what is this? The whole point of it is to help you prepare, face investors and being able to raise capital. Now, what is the process? The process that we do is a process that takes, and I know some of you have seen the slides, so I go at marhaba. I go to the slide. The process is to do first a gap analysis. What is working, what is not working within your organization. Try to be as open about it, and this helps the coach, but helps you in terms of identifying what are your key priorities. Okay, so this is one, the first phase that we'll do. The second phase that we have is the business model canvas. I'm not going to go into the detail, but this is on one sheet, is how you are able to be able to position your company, your customer segments, your competitors, all under one poster, and the whole team works on it. It's a workshop that we will also be implementing. This one is the one we're touching today. It's the transformation plan that we do, and we'll be working on it and focusing on the two areas that I mentioned. Related to this is both the financial plan and the investment plan. So what is a financial plan? It's when, for instance, Cardio Diagnostic is trying to raise money. What they need to do is need to decide what are they going to do with this money. And they need to give projections of how is this money going to be used and how is this money going to be generating revenue and profit in the years to come. So this is the financial plan and this is the investment plan. We will not touch this. Then you need to look at the different sources of capital. It could be debt, it could be equity. Today I was with a company who had good cash flow. They've put their own money in it, and they said, can we apply? But I said, you don't need money. You have your money. They have a lot of land also that I could use to collateralize debt. If you need, you could raise debt, and you have enough assets to be able to collateralize it. But they say, Constantin, we need the expertise. You could get the coaching. You could pay for the coaching, but you don't need to put the equity behind it. So this is why a question is, do you really need to have equity money or do you need coaching or mentoring services to help you grow? So this is the sort of question that we will address during the source of capital. Then we have to value your company. Then you have to select who is the investment partner that you want to work with. And then you have to go through a due diligence process and finalize your term sheet and negotiation. So all these, il n'y a pas de problème. Donc all these are different steps that a company needs to take in order to be able to raise capital and to be able to prepare themselves to discuss with partners. Now what we do today is we're going to focus, this is a deck, you can get all copies of this. This is a slide deck, you could use it and you could fill in the different elements of the slide deck. So no need to, so all the slides will come to you, Joanna. All you need to do is give your name and contact detail to Joanna and then she will forward your attention. The second thing is that we will be also happy to sit down with you once you have, when Tufik has done his transformation plan, is to be able to review it. So we will come, we will review it, we will kick some tires and decide whether this makes sense or it doesn't make sense. So it's also part of the services that we'll be happy also to provide you on. And same thing for Rami. Christelle, problème? Ok. Je suis en train de transpirer, hein, c'est ça le truc. Ok. So what is the transformation plan? The transformation plan, you start with your elevator pitch. Basically, why do you exist? What are you trying to get? You know, how are you going to use this money and to what benefits? You have to describe your company today And you have to describe in terms of strategy, but also in terms of what is working, not working. This is point three that we will be doing, that we will be working on. Then you need to have a timeline of company and milestone. I'll show you examples. What is your value proposition? I.e., how do you differentiate yourself compared to others? How is the company transformed in 5 years down the road? How is Tufik company going to be looking like? And I'm asking you to be able to dream a bit and to see how the company would be look like. What is the impact? What are the two or three ambitious goals that you need to deliver on in order to be able to meet the move from where you are today to where you want to be? We look at the market opportunity, we look at the competitive landscape, we look at your value chain, your operating plan, we will do your operating plan. So today we will do the company diagnostic and we'll do the operating plan, and there is a very strong correlation between the two. We will also work on the KPIs, and then you have all the other elements. So all these are 18 to 20 slides, not more, that constitute your transformation plan. Now Rima is working on one. She wants to raise funds. So she is working. Joanna is helping her put together her business plan, helping her in terms of shaping it so that she could then meet potential investor, describe what she's trying to do, describe how much funds she needs, and describe why is this money going to be well spent. This is the topic of a transformation plan. So what you'll have here, these slides could be applied. Now in the case of a fund like Beritech Fund 1 or Beritech Fund 2, what we want is we want to know what this operating plan is. When our friends from Beritech Fund 2 comes and present what the company is doing, at the end, what we want as investors is we want to know what are the deliverables that will come up at the end of this quarter, the end of the second quarter, the end of the third quarter, and the operating plan is the answer behind it. So in this case, what we have in the case of Suhail, so I say, Suhail, this is good. You're showing me these companies, you're showing me what they've been doing, but I want to have a clear, balanced scorecard on how you are tracking the development of these companies, and I would like to have this implemented across all of your companies. They've started, they work together, and they started with one, and the whole point here is trying to formalize it and have this as a process that we could monitor the companies as these companies evolve with time. Okay? So this is, now, on this transformation plan, you have, the first one is the elevator pitch. All you'll need to do is you'll take these slides and you have to fill them and put what is. The elevator pitch is a one-liner that combines your current mission. Mission is why do you exist? What is your product that you're trying to offer? What is the core activity of your business? And what are the benefits to your customer? So this would be, so for instance, one company that we've been following in the printing business, Havila is the leading one-stop shop for designing and outfitting libraries. We could add to it in West Africa. So this will be an example of what the elevator pitch could be. One sentence or two sentences describing your company, describing why you exist, what do you do, who is your customer, and what are the benefits. So this is one, and a number of you have gone through. So when you go through an accelerator, one of the things that they train you is how do you put together this, this elevator pitch. The mission statement is the second one. The mission is whom you serve, how you do so, and what is the outcome you create. It evokes emotions, convey your reason for being, send chills down the spine. So this will be the mission statement. We will not spend time on your mission statement, but this is something that you need to be clear. So if I ask Tufik what is his mission statement, and I ask, I forgot your name. Joel. And I ask Joel, if I get different answers, there is clearly no alignment behind it. So there is maybe work to be done between the, in terms of why do we exist as a company. So this is something that you also need to do, and to get external help from a coach to help you through, each one of them is a workshop by itself. Okay, so it's a session with your entire team. Now, example of mission statements. This one, you are in mobile cloud. To expand the mobile cloud to do more for businesses and people across Africa. To be the premier specialized care facilities providing excellent health care to women and children across West Africa. This, by the way, were used for the companies that we have coached and we have funded in West Africa with Stanford Seed over the past 2 years. So this is why you'll have a number of cases coming from West Africa. Here it's to be the leading provider of quality, certified and affordable healthcare products to consumer and reduce mortality rate in West Africa. So what is he doing? He wants to be the leading. We need to define what leadings mean in terms of market share. He wants to have quality, certified and affordable. This is his value proposition to the customers. Healthcare products, to whom, to consumers, what is the benefit to reduce mortality rate in West Africa? One sentence. You've introduced who you are, what is your product, who is your customer, and what are the benefits to your customer? Clear? Clear. What is it for BerryTech? What is the mission for BerryTech? So it's nurturing innovation?
That's the
model. Nurturing innovation and growing entrepreneurship landscape.
Okay, so we're getting clear. Any other comments on BerryTech's mission? Okay, so this is an example. It's clear. What is missing here is who is the audience? Who is the audience? In the mission, I don't know.
It's
the IT people. So this is normally I would have asked to... Innovative entrepreneur. So this could be. So innovative entrepreneur could be... It's targeting technology. Okay, so you have the name as BerryTech. Okay, then we move to the strategy. Now, I don't want to give a course on strategy here, but typically in strategy, you describe a scope. The scope basically is what is your product? Which market do you want to sell it into? Which market? What is who is your customer? In which market? What is the product that you're selling to these customers? How are you selling it to the customers, and how do you differentiate? These are the five basic questions that you need to be able to answer. I need to know who is BerryTech clients. I need to know what is the product and services that he's selling to these BerryTech clients. I need to know in which market, is it Lebanon, is it Beirut, is it Tripoli on it? And I want to know how does BerryTech differentiate from other hosting or other incubators that they have, and how this differentiator could sustain over a period of time. So this is the one. Now the diagnostic is how is the company doing? What is working and what is not working? And these, what would be the key strengths and weaknesses that you have in the company? This exercise we're going to work on. But I'm introducing it to you. I'm giving you some examples. What you do the diagnostic, it could be across your value chain. You could start from product development. You could look at production. You could look at sales and distribution. You could look at marketing, financial. Any one of these aspects, what is working well for your company? And what are the areas that you feel you need to have improvements and work on? So I'm going to stop at this stage, see whether there are questions, and then you have, some of you are in group of three or four. You have one flip chart here, you have one flip chart in the back, and you have a board here. You have three official teams. You have the BerryTech team, you have to feed your team. I forgot again your name.
Amal.
Amal? Okay, Spotec team. So she doesn't want to be perceived as the boss. So it's Amal's friends. So what you have. So what I'm asking you to do, and for each one of you, you could do it by yourself. I'm going to ask you to think of your strengths and your weaknesses across each of these elements. So you might, this is only a checklist. So I'm asking you now to work as a team and to be able to, I'm going to give you 10 minutes to discuss it as a team and to tell me what are the strengths and weaknesses, and I'll ask one of the team to present it and we'll give feedback to it. Do you understand the exercise?
Yeah.
Okay, so the exercise are the keys. This is the strengths that you have today. So if I look at BerryTech, one obvious strength is the brand name. BerryTech was the first VC incubator that you have in Lebanon that has a history and has also a very large number of companies that nobody else in Lebanon is getting in touch, even in the region. So this is, for me, a definitely strength that you have. Okay, so what I want you to do is I'll ask you to work on your strengths and weaknesses. Any questions on this? Rima, this applies also to you, you know, so it applies to each one. Now, Rami, give Dr. Sterel. Dr. Sterel, Maon? Okay. Fiancon, flip chart horn. Rami, I'm going to ask you for one of you to present your strengths and weaknesses. Okay, we have 10 minutes to do this. It's going to be short exercises, 10 minutes to be able to complete this. Thank you.
Okay. So, with strengths, we said we have a strong brand name, a strong brand recognition. We have an excellent network locally and internationally. We're well recognized as an establishment supporting entrepreneurs. We have a certification called EUBIC, which is a quality certification for incubation services, mm-hmm. and that we maintain for 10 years. We have physical community and communities, so we have the largest space where there are innovative entrepreneurs mm-hmm. in it. We have a comprehensive ecosystem. We start with competitions up to hosting SMEs that are grown internationally and funding, so we can support all sorts of entrepreneurs at mm-hmm. that level. We have the university behind us, so we have UIG behind us. We have a cohesive team, so we're a good team all together. We have sustainable operation financially, which is also good, and we have good governance.
How would you measure good governance?
We have a board, we have a proper line of commands, proper delegation of authorities, and so on. So it's well structured.
Very good. Any questions before he goes on the strengths? Is this clear in terms of the strengths? So the strength is something that is internal to the organization. The opportunities will be external. So these are the strengths that they offer. Now, if I want to push it further with Rami, I will say, okay, out of these strengths, which are the ones that makes you unique compared to other players that we have in Lebanon? So what I'm doing is I'm moving from strengths to a concept called what? A core competency. So this becomes something that is unique about Peritech, because today a few would say sustainable operation, I have it, you know, so we will have. Now, how many of them have the same brand name or brand recognition? Maybe a few. So what I'm asking, this will be at another step, we're not doing it now, but I'm asking, out of these strengths, which are the one that are making you unique versus the others? And once you brainstorm on it, this will be a good answer. But I won't stop here, because Rami is a great guy, his team is a wonderful team, I don't trust them. I don't know if what they are telling me is correct or not. So what I will do is I will ask for validation. Who do I validate it with? I'll go to Tufik, I'll go to other companies, I'll go, and I will ask them. I'll ask them, what do you believe are the key strengths that Peritech is having? So I'm validating what he feels are his key strengths or core competencies. I'm validating them from the customers that they are serving or from the ecosystem that is around it. And this is how I know for sure that this strength is a real strength and it's really a core competency. So the real answer is not what he's telling me. It's a start, and I'm sure that it's over here. But the real answer is to get the validation from the stakeholder. This is why it's important. Christelle, how many times do you do customer survey with your clients, with the companies that you're hosting?
We do it for events. Maybe we've done twice to assess the training needs. So an average of 6 per year.
Okay. Oh, you do quite a lot. So try to get so.
Depends on the, we do it more focused on the activity.
Okay.
Not as an overall, but okay. The overall should be the step that we need to move forward.
Very good. So clear, we move from strengths, out of the strengths, what really are the core competencies, and validate these core competencies with the external stakeholders. This gives you a third pass. Now this is important, because whatever we're going to address in terms of your operation plan or your balanced scorecard will be based on strengthening these core competencies that you have. How do we ensure that he can sustain it? What does he need to do with his team so that, bonjour, so that in 5 years down the road, these core competencies remain the same core competencies? Or the other way to ask the question is, what do you think, Rami, the core competencies of Peritech should be in 5 years? Okay. What? Maybe they're not here. Maybe there is something that is... this is all sorts of exercise that you could do in order to get a validation. So it's not only about strengths. We move from strengths to core competencies. We validate externally, and then we try to ask our question, what are the core competencies today, and what should Peritech competencies should be in 5 years down the road? And then there's going to be a gap, and the ultimate question, Rami, is how are you going to fill the gap? Understand? So this process is a process that applies to everyone. It applies to Joanna. Joanna wants to do this. I know what is her personal development plan, what she wants to do in 10 years down the road. I know what are the competencies that she has today. And I tell her, for you to be able to do this, this is the other core competencies that today you don't have. And then we work together. How do we help her address and build up these core competencies? So what applies to Rami and Peritech applies to every one of you on a personal basis and applies to you as an organization. Okay? So core competencies today versus core competencies in the future. What is the gap? How do we address the gap? Fundamental questions that any organization, any human being needs to be able to ask. I'm sorry to interrupt.
No,
okay, very good. Weaknesses.
Weaknesses. So we have a relatively scaled or optimized team structure. So we have one person for each role relatively. So when you have to have a scaling up, a quick scaling up, we don't have the full resources to move as fast as we want to have, knowing that we're stretched over 3 sites and different operations. So that limits us from growing as fast as we want to grow.
Mm-hmm.
So we're looking into that as an area to work on. Another thing that we want to make sure is that we want to stay startup lean, meaning we are able to adjust at a faster pace.
Mm-hmm.
We have a history of 15 years, which is great. But at the same time, we don't want to move into an institutionalized structure, not able to be steered as a ship as quickly as we want to be. Mm-hmm. So we want to make sure that we are always at
least. But why do you see it as weakness?
Because we've seen a lot of change in the ecosystem in the last 2 years. Mm-hmm. There has been a big boost in a lot of activities. Mm-hmm. And sometimes having a lot of history behind, it's difficult to steer things quickly. Mm-hmm. So we want to make sure that those things are not holding us. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, we have the mechanism to be able to move faster and more.
Okay.
So it's just a more of a preventive measure than mm-hmm. corrective and preventive.
Okay.
We don't necessarily reflect a trendy look. So one of the areas we've been looking at the team is that our corridors sometimes are a bit more institutional. Our offices in space is more of a government office or a school. Mm-hmm. So there is a need to do some mm-hmm. more revisit of the way we portray our community mm-hmm. as an innovative community versus mm-hmm. what it is now. Fundraising to increase support. So mm-hmm. basically one way of doing more services to our entrepreneur is to fundraise mm-hmm. through different donors and activities.
And are you doing fundraising today?
We raise funds through projects. So for example, we're currently in the process of applying to have a smart agri-food innovation hub here
okay.
at Veritech. Mm-hmm. So we go through donors and mm-hmm. propose a project and bring in.
Okay.
And we get EU funding for several projects we work mm-hmm. on. So, so we need to do more.
If, for instance, I ask you, what do you think is the cash gap that you need? So in order to be able to do what you need, how much do you need? Do you have the answer to this? Do you know what?
No,
you don't. Because,
no.
Okay, this will be, okay, so this, because this is important, then we could see how do we get the money. Very good, okay.
Okay. Internet infrastructure has been a pain in terms of quality of service for our tenants, so we're addressing that. Mm-hmm. So that's more infrastructure. Mm-hmm. Difficulty to define what is Veritech or explain what's Veritech to a newcomer or somebody mm-hmm. new in the game of entrepreneurship at first hand. So mm-hmm. Try to simplify the value proposition and make it much more easy to grasp. Or
so what is the value proposition? I'm a new startup. What is your value proposition?
The problem is that we need to interview you to understand where your gaps is to offer you one of the services or a few of the services.
Oh, so you have different value proposition depending who you're talking to.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. We are kind of a one-stop shop.
Yes.
For all your needs.
Okay.
Start or grow a business.
Okay, so one-stop shop for all the needs of the entrepreneur. Okay, all right.
Yeah.
Okay.
But again, it's drilling down that
yes.
makes it.
Yes. Yeah, I agree.
And being able to provide better business development and support services. So this is an area we're working on to increase. So mentoring and coaching and the things that we're partnering up with. With you guys is part of the...
No, I'm part of Veritech.
I know. We want to grow, so yeah. That's a step forward.
Okay, very good. Yeah. Any questions? You've listened to Rami. He put his strengths and weaknesses. I've recommended what you do with the strengths. Any questions to him first in terms of clarity?
Sorry, I wasn't
streaming. Okay, so...
It's staying lean was more towards ensuring that we are able to follow trends and adjust to needs of the community in a faster way than being institutionalized in a slower pace.
Can I explain it? So when corporations or businesses or institutions get very large, they begin to function like a cruise ship. A cruise ship cannot make decisions quickly, cannot turn left or right very quickly. Versus startups or businesses that function with a goal of innovation, they must be able to make decisions quickly and function a little more like a motorboat. As soon as they see a certain market demand or a change in technology, respond to that right away. And so as an institution here that helps startups, practicing what they preach is very important, and among that is staying lean.
Very good, thank you. Okay, so this is an important thing. Now, for those of you who attended the personal development workshop, we did exactly the same thing, but for you as a human being. So what are the strengths? What are the weaknesses that you have? And then I work on development plan with some of you. We work on the development plan to be able to address it. Now, what I would have done on the weaknesses is I would say, okay, I will sit down with the team and to prioritize. So I want to know what are the most pain, what is the greatest pain that today Rami is facing. So if I ask you to put priority and to choose out of this four, which do you think the four would be?
The four would be, I would say increasing fundraising activities.
Okay, increasing fundraising activities. What else?
Because this will directly affect
the others.
This one.
Yeah.
And internet and trendiness is a quick fix. It's
yes.
It's a matter of deciding and moving forward.
Yes.
Staying lean. And adjusting the structure of the team to be more able to.
So these are the three. So what you're doing as a coach, you will then work and try to look, these are the key pain points that they have. Any other pain points that are facing? So how do you know whether Rami, I will talk to the team members, I will probably talk to the boards, I will talk to other stakeholders. What do you think are the areas? So I will go to Tufi. Tufi, anything that you want to add? You're a customer of Berry Tech today on this list that is not here in terms of weaknesses. Would you add another one?
I think they should work a little bit. As Berry Tech here in Masuri, I think they should work a little bit on the management cost. I think that the building is costing too much.
Mm-hmm. Because you have it reflected in terms of overhead charges. So you have your rent, plus you have some, on top of the rent, you have some others, or it's all included?
It's a lump sum.
But
we believe that there's lots of things like the AC, they can invest in the AC, get an AC which draws much lower power.
Okay.
All right, which will reflect on...
Okay, so basically there are some potential savings in terms of the operating expenses that you could have. So this will be one feedback. Okay, yes?
That's true.
Yeah, so we have this. Clear? So we have now, so we have, yes, question. Okay, so what we're doing now is we're validating. Mm-hmm. So the weaknesses is coming from Christelle, coming from the team, coming from Jessica. We're getting, this is only a few people. If we do this and we ask, 20 of the people, you will get maybe a different list from here. So this is something that I would encourage you when you work with companies or when you work with companies, trying to validate whether these are the right, this is your perspective of what the weaknesses are. Always get a validation from the stakeholders that have around you. This is critical. Okay? Clear? Thank you, Rami. Anybody else wants to volunteer on strengths and weaknesses? Yeah, Tufi. But like flip chart, I'm a bit...
I'll get my own flip chart.
So you see, not only you're getting a free coaching, but you're also getting exercises.
أكيد
رينا.
So, هلا سألته قد ايش صار له مع بيري تك؟ قال لي سنة ولا 10 أشهر.
إيه.
So my question, I don't know your position with the company. بس سؤالي هو بيري تك صار له 15 years. في حدا جاي صار له أقل من سنتين.
إيه.
So basically, when looking at these points.
Yes.
We're expecting this is aligned with the board. شان بيحطوا هن بدون الشركة.
Mm-hmm.
What if sorry, I'm not talking, I know your name.
Okay.
What if, so mashallah, he looks very active in everything,
mm-hmm.
very tech, I'm sure Sean,
mm-hmm.
and the board, how much should they be,
No, but okay, let me tell you what the question is. I'm going to help you with the question. What Rima is saying is that Rami is a great guy, full of energy, but he's been on the job for a year and a half. How does he know whether this is reflection of the, not only of the real situation, but is it reflection of what the board would think? So the answer is, one, he was not alone. So he's done it with, normally you do the exercise with the entire team. Normally, Christelle, combien de temps ça fait que tu es là?
7 ans.
7 years for Christelle. Jessica, a day. Less than a year. Who mean can feel bad? Sami Salo at the medicine that you have. So you have people. It's a team effect. The second one is, you're absolutely right. We need to get, and this is the point I was taking, you need to get validation from key stakeholders. Who are the stakeholders? Typically, who are the stakeholders of Tufik's organization? Who do you think the stakeholders of Tufik's organization? What?
Here.
His direct manager.
His peers.
Who else?
Customers.
Customers. Customers. Who else?
Internal,
external customers. So normally the board is definitely one of the stakeholders, because the board is here to set a direction, set priority. He wants budget. One of his things, you know, who is going to approve the budget? It's the board who approves the budget. So this is why it is critical that whatever he thinks is also aligned, and then he needs to see how to be able to influence. So the message behind it, and this is what you and Tufi has to do, is normally when you do this, you look at your stakeholders, you map your stakeholders. You map your stakeholders in terms of who have low influence, who has high influence, who has low impact, who has high impact, and you put, these are the people who have high influence and high impact, and then you decide to be able to, what are their needs and how best to address these needs. This is also an important exercise that you need to do across any organization that you talk to. Who are my stakeholders? Mapping them in terms of a zone of influence and zone of impact, and then deciding what the needs are and how best to address the needs. Is it face-to-face? Is it a newsletter? Is it an internet site? It would be different ways. This is part of his communication plan that he needs to do with his key stakeholders. Do you have a list of your key stakeholders?
Yes.
You have it. Do you know what the needs are of the different stakeholders?
The way you presented, no.
No, but this will be an interesting exercise to do.
Definitely.
And then not only how to map them, but I'm asking you then, you know, you have the needs, then trying to tell me how you're going to address this need. When he does this, then he has a proper communication plan with this. So includes the board. So the boards are clearly influential, high influence. Impact on the board, it could be medium to high in terms of the employees will be important. His customers. I mean, if his customers, as a Tufi, who بيعمل بيشتغل مع كلهم, بيقولوا لا مش يعني we want a 10% salary cut, 10% cut in terms of your rents, it's too much, and there are about 50 of them, he's in a hell of a shitty position, you know. So you need to look at each of these customers, understand the needs, and be able to address. And very few companies do this mapping. So this is another exercise. أريما. شو سألنا؟ جاوبنا على السؤال؟
لا بس بدي أقول لك بعد شيء كفاية بس
تخلص. لا خلصنا.
He has different views للشركة.
It's a good point.
This is how they do it. مزبوط. They understand the
okay.
هو قدر يروح لحدا من الناس اللي عم بيعطوا مصاري وقال لهم with this plan I can get money from this person a lot of money. How would that affect the company?
Okay.
Board and a different opinion on how to run the
okay. Now, ultimately, a board is a key decision maker. So whenever, why is a board here? A board, normally, you ask Sami, that's been on a number of boards. A board is typically here. The first thing, what is the first thing a board does? Okay, approve the plan first. Yeah. Approve the plan. The plan is the budget. So what is the budget behind it? What is the other thing a board does? Okay, you could, I mean, the board, the CEO, so you normally would have a CEO on it, and depending on the board, they might decide. What else would a board do? Okay, so strategy would be normally part of the business plan, but you're right saying strategy on the long term. A business plan could be for 2017. The strategy when Rami is going to do his offside, they would validate whether he's going in the right direction. What else would the board do? Yes.
Appoint auditors,
clearly. You have appoint auditors. What else? They would approve the budgets. I'm sorry?
Acquisition.
There could be major investments, so whatever major investment, acquisition, major capital investment, expansion in a new country, so all the things that will cost money a board has to approve. What else?
Distribution of dividends.
Hopefully Tufi, are you making money, Tufi? You're on the way to make profits? Okay, whenever Tufi is going to make a lot of money, what happens? What happens? The shareholder will come and will say what? We'll say we invested in your company صار لها خمس سنين عم نمولك يا توفي هلا بدنا شيء ناخذ شيء مصاري بجيبتنا. So the dividend policy is something that is also approved by the board. So what I'm saying is that the board has a number of decisions, but one of the decisions of the board is to approve whatever plan or thinking that he has. So if I'm in the place of Rami, to answer your question, I will come and I'll say, look, this is not working. I believe I need to do 1, 2, 3, 4. But these might be completely outside the normal. So this is what you're saying. So he's coming up with completely new ideas. So what you need to do is you validate it. So you validate it. You start one-on-ones. You start one-on-one with some of the management team, senior management team. You want to go to one or the two of the board members who know you, who trust you. You discuss with them. They give you feedback on it. And then you decide, okay, does this make sense or it doesn't make sense? I give you an example. When we launched the CTP program with Joanna, and initially we knew that some people would resist it. So we knew it. So what did he do? I took this and I decided to launch it with Nasser. So I said, Nasser, give me your opinion. Nasser is an influential person on the board. Nasser came with his feedback before we had the discussion with Maroon and with Nicolas to be able to do this. So these are examples of what Rami would do in order to be able to help implement ideas that might be, because here people will say, Constantin, coaching, ma'am, na 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 na. Suhail will say, this is my job, ya ami Constantin, shu bidifik, ana, khalini amil shirli, ana bidde odmal, I'm exaggerating, of course. But these are sort of things that you need to see. There will be people resisting it. You need to accept the fact, and you need to work with other stakeholders in order to be able to neutralize and move this in the favorite position. So this is Rami's job. It's Rami's job to know who are these stakeholders. Some of them might not be on the board. Some of them might be people that are close to some of the board members. Maroon might have two or three people, his lawyer, might have Sami he wants to talk to, that are not even on the board of Beritech. But he will say, and Rami should know who is the close circle around it and how do I go and talk to him. So this is all part of what? Of building a communication plan. So understanding who the stakeholders are, understanding what their needs are, and they might have different needs, and seeing what is the best way to communicate with each and to influence them. The more you know about them, the more you know what their needs is, the less surprised you will be. When Joanna came, said, Constantin, why didn't you do this? I won't mention what she suggested. I said, look, if I do this, I know how they're going to react. So then she came, she had a discussion with another person. She said, Constantin, you're absolutely right. If you have done this, they would have killed you and put you in peace. So you need to predict how people are going to respond to whatever you're putting together. Did I answer the question? Good. Tufiya khadna min wa'atak.
Okay. I'll present a little bit the strengths of the company. We have a good knowledgeable management team. The team is managed by myself and my wife. We have, each one has around 20 years of experience in the IT sector.
Mm-hmm.
We are always working on innovative products.
Mm-hmm.
So we always introduce products that are required by the local market, and especially by SMEs.
Mm-hmm.
We have, since the beginning, we have defined our business processes with the, towards the client and internally.
Mm-hmm.
There's a potential market out there.
Mm-hmm.
It's at the same time a strength, but mm-hmm. a weakness, because mm-hmm. we're not able to scale enough mm-hmm. in order to catch that,
okay.
that market. We have an engaged team,
mm-hmm.
but at the same time, we have problems in keeping
mm-hmm.
This team.
Mm-hmm.
Mainly, there's a problem in Lebanon called Dubai.
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
All right, so we get fresh graduates. They
mm-hmm.
have their experience mm-hmm. here. They have a nice
mm-hmm.
CV, and then they ship mm-hmm. to Dubai.
Mm-hmm.
I'll get back a little bit to our weaknesses.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a knowledgeable management, but at the same time, it's a little bit a one-man show.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so all the knowledge is limited to myself.
Mm-hmm.
I try as much as possible to provide the team
mm-hmm.
With this knowledge,
mm-hmm.
but we believe that we should have around in the company a duplica of myself,
mm-hmm.
all right? So in order to, for
okay.
the company to be able to grow,
mm-hmm.
all right? All of this is limited to,
mm-hmm.
we have limited finance.
Mm-hmm.
Up to now, the company is financed by myself,
mm-hmm.
all right? So I think 2017 is the time to go and look for
mm-hmm.
Financing in mm-hmm. order for us to implement our
company. Okay.
We have a lack of sales team.
Mm-hmm.
This is related also to the one-man show. Sales
mm-hmm.
is handled by myself.
Mm-hmm.
We have a scalability issue, right? We are not able to scale quickly,
mm-hmm.
right? We are a little bit slow when
mm-hmm.
We have new clients coming
mm-hmm.
in.
And the team retention
that
you mentioned.
We talked about team retention.
Mm-hmm.
At the same time, we have an engaged team,
mm-hmm.
but we are not able to keep them,
to keep them
more than 2 years,
okay.
2.5 years. After that...
any questions to Tufi?
What do you say?
Good question. we started around 8 years ago. We started as managed IT services. What we did at that time, we installed and managed the infrastructure and the IT platform at the client side. At the beginning of 2016, we started building our own cloud solution. It is based here in Beritech, right? So it's not neither Microsoft, neither Oracle or other companies. It is hosted here, and we provide these services to the local SME market.
What's the name of the company?
Pardon?
The name of your company?
Intelligence.
But now with Microsoft doing the iCloud,
it's not
the same potential market, you think?
For us it's not a competition.
It's not
a competition. Microsoft is expensive. Whenever you want to go, we tested it. As a first step, we tested it.
For you to survive, you need to be more expensive.
No. You don't. No.
You're saying you have limited finance.
Yeah, we have limited finance, but in bringing
so
investment, you can build.
So you give us a solution that's similar to Microsoft?
Yeah, but at a cheaper price.
Really cheaper?
Yeah. Yeah,
but
if you do the
insurance that it's Microsoft is the very big company.
Okay, what will you do?
Now,
what will you
now
do
the
if
iCloud
you put your
is trending. Now it's beginning. So now you have like a higher step to go.
You cannot move all the company to the cloud. Okay?
No,
I'll tell you one thing. If you are providing ERP services, what happens if you have an internet breakdown?
Yeah,
okay.
Sure.
Let's say we have an internet breakdown in Lebanon.
But look,
you cannot tell the company that
you're in an unsafe country.
Yeah.
That's your advantage.
No, that's one. Second, second, you have sometimes, especially if you go into finance, financial information should reside in the country. All countries are implementing laws whereby they are obliging companies to have their financial information based in the country and not stored outside the country.
Okay, look, but this question is very good, and it's part of the other section, which is his value proposition and competitive differentiator.
Yeah.
So we will go there, but it's a very important one. Now I want to spend time on this. This is quite important because what he has done, he has been open and he has been transparent. And the sort of issues that you have here, strengths and weaknesses, is very typical of a number of startups. Now, what I have here, he's put the potential market. This is not a, remember, strengths and weaknesses are what are internal. It's an opportunity. So opportunity and the team retention is a threat. What is the threat? Poaching. Poaching is happening, and this is applicable. Why? Because he's paying 1,000, 1,500, whatever it is going to be. And in Dubai, I would get twice the salary, three times the salary. Actually, the poaching is not only Dubai. The poaching is now, we have $600 million of money going into startup. Where do you think this money is being used for? What do you think is, cardio diagnostic is there. I won't mention the person, but we're hiring a person. You know how much we're paying this person? We're paying this person $12,000 a month to be able to get it. So where is he going? He's poaching. He's poaching people. So these are companies. Most of the money that we're putting in the market is going into hires because he needs a talent team. So there is a lot of poaching, not only from Dubai, but from the other companies that are in the system that are also poaching others because you have very limited resources here in Lebanon. So it's a big issue. It's a big issue. And if you don't address this issue, no matter how you end up being the sole player, and if he's the sole player, something happens to him, the whole company goes down the drain. So this is a huge vulnerability. In terms of risk, I think this is a top risk. And most of the startups are in the same position. Most of the startups, it's one person having everything in mind, and it is critical for him to make sure that he has a clear succession plan, somebody who can take over. If my question to most of the entrepreneurs, if you cannot take a month's holiday, there is something wrong, you know. And it's we have other companies that are going to here. And then Michel Chamas is the head of Bsynchro. He said, Constantin, I took 2 weeks holiday. It's my first start. I was there and I was in France with the family. This is great. But most of the entrepreneurs are proud. You know, I was there for the past 5 years and I worked on it. And they're very happy. And for me, when they tell me this as an investor, I'm scared shit. You know, if this person didn't take a day of holiday, there is no way I'm going to invest in this company because there is no plan B. So all of these things are bringing what? Are bringing implementation issue that we need to have. On the one-man show, who is going to be your number two? What are you going to do in order to make sure that this number two is going to be developed? In case something happens, I'm talking now purely as an investor point of view. Limited finance, this is critical because most of the things that he needs to have finance. Now funds are available. Is he able to be able to package it? Does he have a transformation plan? Does he have a complete team? Does he know how to talk to these investors, to go to Suhail, to others, to Sami, to be able to discuss? Most of them are not prepared. Have you been through a capital raising fund in the past or not? Not yet. So this needs preparation. So all by itself, it would lead to some strategic priorities that we will have to implement. And this will show in the roadmap that we're going to do. Lack of sales team. Most of the companies don't have a sales team. Most of the companies don't, and he ends up being the whole salesperson. This is wrong, because he ends up doing everything. So you need to make sure that you have an appointed salesperson. And in the case of cardiodiagnostic, the first position that we wanted to hire, and he's making three times the salary of the founder. Three times his salary is to get somebody who is going to drive sales, going to drive business development. And for this, he said, Constantin, I need to pay this. You have to pay it. But to pay it, what does he need? He needs finance. If he doesn't have finance, he won't be able to implement. Then we get into a vicious circle. So why is this important? Because this is going to force you to think, what do I need to do in order to make sure that these weaknesses are addressed over the 6 to 12 months? Lack of sales team, scalability issue is quite critical. It's also related to funds behind it. And team retention, I'm mentioning some examples, but one of the things that we have approved, and we went even to the Berry Tech Fund, is one of the companies said, we want to go and implement an ESOP. How many of you know what an ESOP is? What do you think an ESOP is? Okay, Suhail knows, of course.
Is it a bird in Africa?
It's in the bird in Africa. So we have ESOP is an employee stock option program. So what we have now is we're introducing with a number of the companies in order to address this. We cannot pay the guy what the guy has been making. He was working for Medtronics, he was working and he was making $20,000 a month. We cannot pay as a startup. So what do? We say, fine, we give you maybe half, but we will give you stock options. We give you either virtual or real stocks in the company so that if the company increase in value, you end up cashing it, and this could be at least twice what the company is being able to make. So every one of those will have a strategic initiative behind it, and this strategic initiative will become his roadmap for the next 3 to 6 months. You understand what I'm trying to do? Is how do we move from this to move to what is he going to, if not, is going to have this list in a year or 2 years down the road, and if he's not lucky in 3 years down the road, he won't be around because he would not have addressed it. So we list them in order to see what is the burning ones, and then what we do is we work together, what are we going to do to address those? Clear? Questions? Now on the strength side, it's the same thing. How can we maintain his innovative products? Then I will zoom in. How do you come up with new products? How do you get your ideas? How do you develop a product? How do you test that this product is responding to a real need? So I'll start zooming in with him and trying to find out where really it is innovative product. Then if it is the case, how can we maintain this innovativeness that is aspect in it? It's the way he's developing, is it the way he's testing, is it the way that he is marketing it? So this by itself is, and to maintain it, probably funding is going to be needed because he would need to have skill set. Well defined, okay, this is important, and a number of companies don't have it, but this is the backbone. If you don't have this, you will have problem, SOPs, policies and procedures, all these, and normally this is linked to what? To the ERP system. So Navision and others will then take these SOPs and implement, and most companies don't have this, and most companies don't have an ERP system, and it is a need. You cannot grow a company if you don't have your foundation in place in terms of business controls and financial controls. So this is, so do you understand what we do? Strengths and weaknesses, this is going to drive what? It's going to drive the next exercise that we'll do will be on the strategic priorities that Tufiq will have with his team. Questions to Tufiq? Yes?
Nine people. Should you have much kind of
scalability?
Is it the money?
Yeah, sure. You need, we work a lot with fresh graduates. You need to start addressing this issue. Once you address this issue, address this issue. In order to address this issue, you need to address this issue.
How do you apply for finance? Do you say, I have this product that I'm raising money for? What are the whole company?
We still did not apply. This is our plan for 2017.
For instance, coming to this, because this he will have at least what does the transformation look like. All you have to do is take these slides and fill them. So, and then get validation. Not only him, ideally is to do it with the team, and then have somebody to facilitate it, ideally a coach. So Rami have understood it, he will have a coach there, and then the coach will come and help you in terms of putting it together, packaging it, and helping you sell it to these investors. Okay? So this is important. Thank you, Tofi. Thank you. Rami, thank you, Tofi. Rami, also thanks.